Hey guys, welcome back. Today's video is going to be my current favorites or products and items that I've been loving. And it seems like as of lately, I've been doing these videos every month just because I have so many favorites to share with you. Typically, I'll do them every like 2 to 3 months, but I have a lot of random items as I always do. I have a pet related item. I have some food related or beverage related items. I have some beauty, some fashion, and many more other items to share with you. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, hit the like button and the notification bell down below. And without further ado, if you guys would like to see my current favorites, then just keep watching. So first, let's start off with the pet related favorite I have to share with you. So this is it right here. This is by the company Vofami. And you're thinking it looks like a pet brush, a cat or a dog brush or comb to groom your pets. But yes, it is that, but it is also an electric vapor cleaner and brush. So basically what that means is that while you're grooming your pets, you can give them kind of like a bath as well. I know that sounds crazy. Once we had to put Koala in the sink, it was like last year, and it was terrifying for her. She hated water, she did not like it. And I know there's like a lot of other, even dogs that don't like taking baths, it can be really challenging. So that's where this comes in. So it comes with two brush heads right here and they kind of just lock on. And then next it comes with three of these shampoo cartridges that you're gonna stick into the brush. They are non-toxic and they are vegan. And I have a little pamphlet that came with it. But it says that perilla extract and ginseng extract are the main ingredients that help soothe and nourish the hair and skin. And it also says that this is antibacterial, which is nice. It is deodorizing, mite removal, which is really cool. I never really thought about that, but you know, my cat is rolling around and everything. She's sleeping everywhere. So that's actually a really cool thing when I use this. It's removing mites from her fur. It also says it degreases and deep cleans. So that's what's really cool about this item, you guys. You don't have to rinse them off afterwards. So basically you take the little cartridge. I'm not gonna take this cap off just because I don't want it, you know, going everywhere, but you're going to pop it in right here like so, and then you're gonna press the button on. As you can see, it's on, and then it's gonna squirt out like a spray of the gentle shampoo, and then you're just going to brush your pet. And I'll insert a video if I haven't already showing you how I use this on Koala. And then once you're done, it comes with this nice microfiber cloth that you kind of just wipe them down because they might still be a little bit damp, so you just wipe them down and you're good to go. And I think that is way easier than putting a pet in a sink or a bathtub to give them a bath. If you guys are interested in this electric vapor brush, I will have it linked down below. Okay, so next let's get into food or beverage related items. I don't think I have any food, it's just more beverages. So this, I don't know if they just came out with this or not, but this is the Peppermint Mocha Califia, if I'm saying that correctly, Farms Creamer. And this is almond milk creamer, which is really nice. It's only 15 calories. Regular creamers, even like the creamer I buy for my husband, I either get them the Starbucks one or the Coffee Mate ones. The calories on those are like 35 to 40 calories per one tablespoon, and you're not paying attention when you're pouring. So if you're not careful, you could have like over 100 calories of creamer in just one cup of coffee. So this has a little bit less calories, which is nice. There's no, or I think there's like what, 2 grams of sugar. The other regular creamers have a lot more sugar, and this is not dairy, it's almond milk. So I really like this. It's got 2 grams of carbs, so it's really light in a nutshell, but the flavor's really nice. Now, if you were to have this along with the Peppermint Mocha Starbucks ground coffee that I shared in my last favorites video, it tastes really nice. It also tastes really nice with just regular non-flavored ground coffee. So I did want to shout this out. I got this at Target. They don't really sell a lot of this brand at Walmart. I think they maybe just sell like the almond milk, but they don't really sell their creamers. But at Target, they do sell this, and probably like your local grocery stores as well. So I wanted to shout this out, especially kind of like in the winter around the holidays. This is a really nice creamer. The Coffee Mate Peppermint Mocha one is nice as well. But again, it's just a lot more more calories and sugar. And then for Dunkin' Donuts, because I'm not going to neglect that, it's going to be peppermint mocha coffee again. But they did come out, actually, I'm not really sure, because when I went to Dunkin' like 3 or 4 days ago and went to order their white chocolate, they said that they didn't have it and they discontinued it, and they just came out with it. So comment down below if you know if that's like a fact or not. But I did like the white chocolate flavor for the coffees as well. I hope they didn't get rid of it, but the peppermint mocha has been my go-to, and I typically will just get 1 to 2 pumps less of the flavor, and then I might get some almond milk. I don't do cream and sugar because those flavor shots are just really sweet as it is. Next, I have tape and hair extensions that I wanted to share with you guys. I typically don't mention tape and hair extensions. I always usually go with the clip-ins, but especially more around like my face and right here where I have a lot of like my short bang pieces, I like to either cut the tape and hair extensions in half and just put little pieces there that it doesn't look bulky, because if I put clips up here, it can look bulky sometimes. So that's where the tape and hair extensions come in. The extensions that I have in are from Amazing Beauty Hair Extensions. This is what the box looks like. And I have one more pack left over, but this is kind of like what their extensions look like, and I have 20 inches in the shade 60, or that's ash blonde, I want to say. I always get confused with ash blonde and platinum, but platinum is 613, ash is 60. It comes with extra double-sided tape if you want to reuse them once you take them out and you want to reinstall them. So it comes with extra tape, which is nice. And then they come with a little brush, or actually not a brush, it comes with a comb. And then it also comes with a clip to kind of section off your hair. So it's nice that they include that. Now, I have a little bit of hair left over from when I was applying these the other day from one of my other packs. So that's what it looks like. The quality is really nice. I've tried their clip-ins before, never their tape-ins, but their tape-ins are awesome. I have seen and tried other tape-ins before, and when I get them, they the ends are just like so flat and so blunt, and it looks really choppy when you put them in, and that's what I really like about these. It doesn't look like that at all. I've seen others where it's just so, like, it looks like a chopped look, and then it doesn't blend in nicely with my hair. This blends in nicely. I do have some clip-ins in the back, but in the front I have the tape-ins. I'm going to show you in a second. But it's really soft, really nice quality. You can color this if you want. I actually didn't put low lights in through it. I went a little bit blonder, so I didn't really feel the need to put low lights through it. I'm going to get close up so you can see, but you can see the weft right there. So I like to put them right up front so I don't have to have the bulky one piece clips right there, because sometimes it can just look too bulky, and sometimes it can really irritate my scalp too. Like when I have clip-ins in the back, not so much, but here where the hair is a little bit thinner and I have the clip-ins, it kind of tugs on my scalp. It feels weird. It can get bulky. So that's why I like to kind of put some tape-ins right there. I have one Bath & Body Works item to share with you. I'm filming a Bath & Body Works haul right after this video with a lot of candles and other items, so I didn't want to go crazy in this video, so I just narrowed it down to one candle. And I was actually hoping that they brought this back this year. It is vanilla balsam, and I love this. I like this better than fresh balsam. It just smells so nice. This is a brand new one. It smells so nice. I don't know if they have the concentrated room sprays this year, but last year I purchased a few and those smell nice. I don't think they had any of the bulbs in the vanilla balsam this year. Maybe they just added them. But this is a really nice scent, you guys. I really like it. The notes for this are balsam fir, frosted vanilla, snow-capped pine needles with natural essential oils. I would definitely recommend this one. It just smells really nice. Okay, so next I have a really large item to share with you, but it is an advent calendar. And this isn't a normal advent calendar or Christmas calendar, countdown to Christmas. It has 24 slots on it, but this is by Clarins. And I think this would be a really cute gift for somebody. But every day you open up, there is like a travel size product of there. So it's like makeup or skincare, anything like that. So one of the gifts from like the other day was this blush right here, you guys. And I actually have this blush on today. It is their Jolie blush in the shade Cheeky Pink. So this was, I think, like the 1st or 2nd of December, but the blush is really beautiful. So every day it's a nice gift. It comes with this little pamphlet to kind of refer to everything that you're getting. But you're getting like 24 items, you guys. So I didn't open today's up yet. So let's see what today's is. Is today the 6th? I don't even know what day it is. Did I open the 5th? Let's see. Yeah, I did do the 5th. So we will see for the 6th. So today is their energizing emulsion. It soothes tired legs. So that's a really unique product. It's really kind of exciting to go up to this every day and open and see what I'm going to get. And it's really fun and you get a lot of products. So if you guys are interested in this, this would be a good gift for somebody as well. I will link this down below. I have 3 beauty items and then 1 fashion item left. This right here is a very new favorite. Like, within the last week, it just became a favorite that I wanted to share with you guys. This is the Saint Tropez. I used to say Saint Tropez, but now I say Saint Tropez. I don't know. But anyways, it's their self-tan purity spray. It's their natural glowing skin bronzing water face mist. This right here. So usually I don't self-tan my face, but if I do, I would just take a little bit that's left over on the mitt after I'm like, dabbing. After I'm blending it out on my arms or my chest, whatever's left over, I would kind of just like go over on my face. But sometimes I don't like the way it looks. So I typically don't self-tan my face and I'll just go with a darker foundation color. So I was going through my cabinets in my bathroom the other day and I found this stuff. I got it last year and I like forgot about it. So I used this over the weekend and then I just took my little tanning mitt or the glove that usually it comes with whenever you buy whatever tanning mousse, or you can buy them separately as well. And I just sprayed this mist on and then kind of like blended it and dabbed it in. I will say a little bit goes a long way because you're spraying it on and you're thinking, oh, I don't see any color. Oh, I don't know what's going to come out as. A little bit goes a long way with this, you guys. So this looks awesome and it gives you like a really natural look. It almost looks like you laid out in the sun and you have not like a sunburn, but just like it gives you almost like a nice reddish tan like tint to your face. Like it looks natural. That's what I'm trying to say. It doesn't look like tan, like self-tanner all over your face. It actually just gives you a really nice natural glow. Again, a little bit goes a long way, so I did want to shout this out. And then next, let's get into makeup. These are 2 new items. I ordered these, I think around like Black Friday from Too Faced website because they had a nice sale going on and I think they had like 30% off. So this is the Too Faced Natural Face Palette. And if I can open this up, that's what it looks like. It comes with 2 blush shades, 2 highlight shades, and 2 bronzer shades. This bronzer shade I haven't really used yet, but this one right here is really nice. And this is nice too because then I'm not like reaching for separate bronzers, separate blushes, separate highlighters. They blend out really nice. I really like them. So this is what I went with. Perfect for traveling. Definitely consolidates products. You're not bringing everything. And then I decided to try out the Too Faced Born This Way, the Natural Nudes eyeshadow palette. That's what the packaging looked like. And this is really lightweight compared to like the other Too Faced palettes that are like metal, like the chocolate bar, all the candy bar palettes, or the sweet peach palettes, or any of those. This is definitely more lightweight, but it's a nude palette. Very nice. They have mattes and shimmers, which I love. I don't like all shimmer palettes, and I don't like all matte palettes, so this is every color that I would possibly need. I'm obsessed with it. This is probably my favorite neutral palette so far. I wouldn't need any other colors. If I was traveling, this would be the palette that I would go with. I will say that there is a little bit of fallout, but it doesn't bother me. But yeah, blends out really nicely. I really like the color. So those are the 2 items that I picked up and I've been loving. And then last but not least, I did mention these in a recent Amazon haul, but I just love them so much. I wear them like all the time, you guys. I get so many compliments on them, but they are these faux leather leggings. And they are from the brand Retro Gone, but these are from Amazon. Now, I will say that these were like $50, and typically I would never spend that much money on a pair of leggings, but these were so worth it, you guys. They're high-waisted. You can wear them with nice tops or blouses, and you can wear boots with them, and I just love them. They're super comfortable, super stretchy. And I like, they're kind of like a shiny faux leather, if you will. They're not like, or not shiny, but they're like kind of like shimmery. I don't know how well that picks up on camera, but they're not like that really like shiny plasticky look. I don't really like that. So I wanted to shout these out. I'll insert a picture so you guys can see what they look like. I went with the size small. I was going to do extra small, but I stuck to the small and I'm actually glad I did. So maybe size up, but I was reading like a lot of the reviews to see what size I should go with. But they are not 7/8 length. That's the only thing I wanted to mention. So when I do wear these, I either have Uggs on or boots on because they are a little bit longer, you know, more so toward my ankles because I am shorter. So I did want to mention that. But other than that, I absolutely love these. Okay, you guys, so we finally made it through my current favorites. Let me know in the comments down below if you've tried out any of these items, if you're thinking of trying out any of these items. What have your current favorites been for this month? I would be curious to find out, but anyways, that is it. I hope you guys have a wonderful week, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.